Well, good afternoon, everyone. Thank you so much for joining us today. It was on March 15th of this year that we launched our Better Education Starts Today strategy. This five-year strategy is dedicated to making Manitoba's educational system the most improved in Canada. The BEST strategy focuses on four pillars. One, to improve learning and outcomes for all students across the province through high and measurable standards of excellence. Two, to engage students and build competencies for lifelong success. Three, ensure teachers, school staff, and leaders have the knowledge, skills, and tools to support student performance. And four, build a consistent and aligned provincial education system that is accountable for results and engages parents. The objective of our strategy is to put the best interests of students first. Over the past months, the New Democratic Party, Manitoba School Boards Association, and the leadership of the Manitoba Teachers Society have intentionally misled Manitobans with a misinformation campaign on Bill 64. Unfortunately, the purpose of their campaign is to instill fear and anxiety in parents and educators. Our position as government is to create constructive dialogue with parents, frontline teachers, staff, educational experts, community leaders, visible minority, Indigenous people, and Manitobans who want to improve our school system and the lives of our students. What is unfortunate is the political campaign that is happening right now that will not fill the gaps and address the discrepancies in the current system. These parties want to maintain the status quo. The status quo is we're spending the third amount per capita in the country and achieving some of the poorest results. Manitobans and students deserve better. This is a campaign for the political gain of the opposition and the interests of their political friends. It is no coincidence the Manitoba Teachers Society leadership decided to recently align themselves with the Manitoba Federation of Labour, a union whose own policy clearly states, and I quote, "The MFL is a proud affiliate and supporter of the Manitoba New Democratic Party." The policy also says, and I quote, "All affiliated unions are encouraged to affiliate with the NDP and encourage their members to participate actively." On May 18th, the president of the Manitoba Teachers Society wrote, "Partisan politics does not belong in the classroom." And I agree. However, the union leadership decided to take politics to the classroom, whereby the MTS leadership and the MFL are putting pressure on teachers to purchase NDP memberships. Because of this campaign and the misconceptions being spread, our department has released a fact versus fiction webpage at bettereducationmb.ca/fact versus fiction. This is the opportunity for Manitobans to make an informed decisions with the proper information. Manitobans should know there will be no disruptions for teachers, students, and everyday life in the classroom. Teachers will not be penalized for poor assessment results of their students. And furthermore, the department cannot close schools without community consultation. Although Bill 64 does not specifically address issues such as poverty, mental health, and special needs, as those are issues that are not legislative, but policy-based. And these issues will require a whole-of-government approach. And our view is to consult with Manitobans over the coming months and the coming years to determine better outcomes on these issues. School community councils will increase marginalized, visible minority, and Indigenous voices in the education system. Government will not appoint principals, as they will continue to be hired through a competitive process and will also be required to be certified teachers. These are a number of examples. The NDP, Manitoba School Boards Association, and Manitoba Teachers Society leadership have been distorting. In order to make progress on improving education as a whole, Manitobans need to turn their attention to our best strategy at bettereducationmb.ca. Do not be distracted by a campaign designed for the political gain of the opposition and their political friends. We as a government are working with and gathering the insight of frontline teachers, principals, and school staff, utilizing educational experts and talking with parents who know firsthand the needs of their students. We have had a tremendous response and feedback from our teacher listening tour, our parent engagement panels, and our telephone town halls. It is by engaging with Manitobans that we will build the roadmap that will create a fairer funding model that doesn't leave any student behind. Direct resources and supports to teachers and frontline staff, and most of all, set up our students for greater success. With that, I would be more than happy to take your questions.
Thank you, Minister. A reminder to our reporters on the line, you will have one preliminary and one follow-up question. Up first this afternoon from the Winnipeg Free Press, Maggie.
Good afternoon, Minister Cullen. Maggie here from the Free Press. My first question for you is, who are the supporters of the BEST strategy and Bill 64, as well as what are the associations that are in favor of this strategy that you're aware of?
Well, thank you. The reason we got into a discussion about K-12 education, I guess probably 2 years ago, we called on a K-12 review, and we consulted with Manitobans. And Manitobans clearly indicated to us there was room for improvement. That's why we embarked on this journey 2 years ago. We took our recommendations, 75 recommendations from the K-12 review, our experience with COVID over the last 16 months, and we formulated a strategy. And we've put that forward to Manitobans. Today's announcement is a reminder for Manitobans to make sure they fully understand Bill 64 and the governance issues related in Bill 64 versus what we're trying to achieve through our Better Education Starts Today strategy. Our strategy will continue to engage Manitobans on a lot of issues that need improvement over the coming months and the coming years. It really is a 5-year strategy to improve K-12 education. So we want to make sure Manitobans completely understand what's in Bill 64 and what we are trying to accomplish in broader terms through our strategy.
Thank you, Minister. I'm going to ask you again, have you heard from any associations that are in favor of Bill 64 and this governance structure or simply the best strategy? And I'm just curious. I know that you've mentioned that there has been a vocal minority that is against this. So what is that majority saying? Who is in support of this roadmap, the planning, everything that's on the table here?
Well, for sure. I mean, we have Bill 64 on the table. That really deals with the governance component. We've had a number of individuals speak highly of the changes that are talked about in the legislation. I think most Manitobans would agree when they look at our strategy going forward. This will be a comprehensive consultation with educators and Manitobans about how we improve the K-12 education in Manitoba. What's happened is we have a campaign directed clearly at Bill 64, I would say politically driven by certain organizations, creating anxiety amongst teachers and anxiety amongst parents by distorting information relative to both Bill 64 and our strategy. And I know this is the wake-up call for Manitobans to take notice, to be clear on what is in Bill 64 and what we're trying to accomplish through our strategy.
From Global News, Rosanna.
Hi, Minister Cullen. This is Rosanna with Global News. Manitoba School Boards Association says the province refuses to provide a reason for how dissolving school boards will benefit students in the classroom. Can you provide that reason?
Sorry, could you repeat that question for me?
Yes. So the Manitoba School Boards Association, they say that the province refuses to provide a reason for how dissolving school boards will benefit students in the classroom. And I'm wondering, can you provide that reason?
Well, sure. I mean, we got into this discussion about how do we improve outcomes in schools in K-12. A number of recommendations came forward, 75 recommendations. I think approximately 8 of those recommendations were around the school governance model. Clearly, the report had pointed out times have changed in terms of school trustees, their roles and responsibilities. We were going to province-wide collective bargaining. We're changing the funding formula when it comes to how we fund K-12 education in the province. So clearly the role of school trustees is changing. And the K-12 report clearly recognized that. We feel by shifting some resources from the administrative side, we think certainly $40 million is attainable. Shift those resources to the front lines will directly impact outcomes for our students. $40 million can be used for potentially hiring more teachers, educational assistants, clinicians, extra resources for students with special needs, and students that are facing mental health challenges. So redirecting that money to the classrooms will have a direct benefit for both teachers and for student outcome.
Thanks for that. Can you give specific examples of misinformation that you say the Teacher Society has been spreading?
Right. I mentioned quite a few in my opening remarks. And I think probably the big thing is there were no major disruptions in everyday classroom activity. Again, there is no intention and never was any intention to close schools. They raised the issue of poverty. Poverty can't be legislated away. We are going to address the poverty issue through our poverty reduction strategy in conjunction with our Poverty Reduction Committee of Cabinet. Our respect for human diversity policy is a requirement in all schools. Furthermore, there will be no penalty for assessment results if they are poor in nature. In fact, quite opposite. If we find assessments are poor in a school, we can add extra resources to support that particular school. We will be trying to eliminate inequities resulting from funding imbalances and implement a new funding model through a review mechanism so that funding is transparent and sustainable. We as government will not be appointing principals, and they will be hired through a competitive process, and they will also be required to be teachers. In fact, Bill 64 creates a mechanism to actually enhance parental engagement. and we're excited about that. And again, we will be putting more resources in the classroom rather than less, redirect that money from administration. And those are just a few of the inaccuracies that that we have heard.
From the Brandon Sun, Kyle.
Hello, Minister. You previously said that teaching Bill 64 in the classroom, that's, you know, teaching this legislation has no place in the classroom. Where does the province draw the line in terms of telling teachers what they can and cannot teach school-aged children?
Right. So the province is responsible for developing the curriculum, and the curriculum clearly lays out what is being taught in schools. It's been probably 25 years since we've had a comprehensive look at the curriculum. That's why we're in the process of putting together a curriculum advisory committee. This will be a diverse group look at our current curriculum and provide some advice in terms of how we move that forward. I will say curriculum development is an ongoing process. It's obviously lots of detailed work. There's certainly a lot of different areas that have to be looked at, and different classes have to be looked at, and levels for sure. So the curriculum development is an ongoing process. We continue to do that, but we want to make sure that we are fully understand the overarching themes around curriculum. That's why we're looking at a provincial advisory committee on curriculum.
All right, thank you. And during this conference, you've accused the NDP and other kind of groups of, you know, of spearheading this anti-Bill 64 campaign for political ends, which is kind of creating anxiety for a lot of Manitobans. What would you say to people who suggest that your government is doing the exact same thing, is that you're using Bill 64 to, you know, push it along just for purely political ends, especially since, you know, it is causing some anxiety for a lot of Manitoba parents and educators?
Yeah, the fact of the matter is we've got engaged in a K-12 review 2 years ago because we wanted to improve student outcomes here in the province. You know, there's no ulterior motive here. We really want to provide better outcomes for our students. We are spending the third highest per capita on education. When we compare ourselves with other jurisdictions in the country, we are either dead last or next to dead last. We think Manitobans deserve better. We do have a good system, but there always is room for improvement. That's why we engaged in this. We want to make our education system the most improved system in the country. That's why we are embarking on the consultation process. This cannot be achieved through Bill 64 alone. That's why we've laid out our strategy with the four pillars, with outcomes for students and outcomes for teachers and leadership as well. And we can't accomplish this overnight. That's why we're in the process of developing a roadmap for Manitobans that they will be clear on where we're going in terms of this improvement. This is a five-year process. Pieces can be accomplished sooner than that, but the reality is with the comprehensive review that we want underway and the engagement process, the comprehensive engagement process we're going to be undertaking, the reality is this is a five-year journey. And we're asking Manitobans to engage with us on that journey.
From CJOB, Skyler.
Hi, Minister Cullen. Thanks for your time this afternoon. You did just mention the, you know, the spending and the learning outcome disparity is quite large when compared to other areas of Canada. I'm just wondering, you know, can both of these be achieved? Can you really save money and, you know, maybe get back to the median when it comes to education spending, but still experience better learning outcomes? Like, how believable is that supposed to be, that both of those can be achieved at the same time?
Well, you know, we recognize it's a lofty goal, but if we're not up to face the challenge and have the conversation, we're going to end up with status quo or worse. So we're taking on the challenge. I get it. Change can be difficult. And certainly we want to engage in Manitobans in this journey. And we need our educators, who are the experts, on this conversation. I'm just disappointed. We have union bosses, the NDP, trying to shut down that discussion. That, to me, is the unfortunate part. We should all be in this together about trying to provide better outcomes for our students. This is about the future of Manitoba. We want Manitoba to be the most improved province, and if we ignore the K-12 education in that conversation, that would be the wrong thing to do.
Okay, thank you for that. You mentioned it's a vocal minority that's, speaking out in opposition of Bill 64, and it very may well be, but I'll be honest, I do see a lot of signs in yards, when I'm driving around. I'm just wondering, if this bill is supposed to put some of that power back in parents' hands, why some parents, are speaking out pretty strongly against it?
Well, and this is exactly why we're having a press conference today. That's why we're trying to make sure parents and educators are getting the factual information. And clearly, some of these agencies have been driving misinformation, distorted information, and adding to the fear and anxiety, which clearly is not necessary at this time. We understand, parents are facing enough challenges. We won't see any changes in the classroom, certainly in the short term. Our goal is actually to put more resources into the classroom to support teachers. And I think it's incumbent upon us as a government to make sure that Manitobans and educators fully understand what we're trying to accomplish on the governance side in Bill 64 and the big picture positive outcomes that we're trying to achieve over a five-year period under the new strategy.
From the Winnipeg Sun, Josh.
Good afternoon, Minister. Josh Aldridge with Winnipeg Sun. You talked about putting more resources in the classroom. And I know over the last number of years, the provincial government has continually increased spending for education. How do you reconcile that when the Winnipeg School Division a couple of weeks ago comes out and talks about having to look at cutting 120 teachers? How does that jive? Because people are looking at comments from the government and the comments from Winnipeg School Division. I know there's other school divisions that have talked about having to make those cuts in the classroom because resources are not there. How do you reconcile those two, those types of things?
Yeah, thanks for that, Josh. Very, very good question indeed. And we just sent a letter to school boards over the last week to say, listen, layoffs are not on the table. We're here to support K-12 education. Now more than ever, we need classroom teachers. We need those educators in the classroom. So these layoffs that have been talked about, from my perspective, for political purposes, are not on. We've said to them, listen, if you're having financial concerns, you call us and let us know, and we will have that conversation. We don't need those conversations to be occurring through the media. And I think that we were very clear with them with our letter of last week that type of situation, that sort of posturing is not on, and the threat of layoffs is not on.
And you've talked quite a bit about the engagement that you guys have been doing over the last number of weeks with town halls and all the rest. Is this just information for parents and educators, or is there that opportunity for the feedback gathering on your end to make changes to Bill 64, or is it just a one-way conversation?
Yeah, no, there's two things here for sure at play in this consultation. First of all, it provides us an opportunity to set the record straight. Clearly, parents have been receiving some misinformation. And this actually provides us an opportunity to see what that misinformation is, set the record straight. So that's certainly helpful. The other thing is we're really focusing on parental engagement. Parents know their kids the best. And research shows the more parental engagement we have at the school level, the better the outcomes for our students. That's critical. And we're trying to figure out what the best practices are across the province. There are some great things happening in schools in terms of that engagement. And we want to see how we can improve that engagement and get it at the school level to provide advice to the leadership at the local school. We think this is critical going forward. We want to make sure that we can support those school community councils with the resources they need and the supports in place to support that advisory capacity so that each school, I know, will have their own priorities. And the community should have the opportunity to express those priorities and provide advice for better education for their students at that school level. So clearly, we're taking that advice. There could be an opportunity for amendments to Bill 64 on that front. And it really, I look forward to our Parental Engagement Task Force, who will be continuing their dialogue with Manitobans over the next few weeks. They will then report back to me and provide recommendations and advice how to move forward. So it is indeed a two-way conversation, and we asking Manitobans to engage in that.
From CBC Manitoba, Ian.
Good afternoon, Minister. You describe a lot of this as misinformation, but in a lot of cases, it's members of the public simply disagreeing with what you say. Why should the public trust that your government will actually make the education system better?
Well, I know there's going to be a percentage of people that certainly disagree with us, and I understand that. But there's those out there, many, that are making their decision based on false information. All we're asking today is for Manitobans to make themselves informed. Make sure you clearly understand Bill 64 in terms of the governance model, but also look at our strategy going forward. This is a journey. This is a five-year journey to improve education in Manitoba. We've always been focused as a government on how we can make Manitoba the most improved province in the country. We can't do that without looking at education. Education is the future for our province. We have to look at ways to make our education system better and provide better outcomes and better opportunities for our students. Manitobans deserve that. And we're going to deliver on that.
Thank you. And there's no debate that there is sort of a big outcry against this bill, and you've resorted to sort of pointing fingers at others. What responsibility do you take for this, and where has the government failed in maybe its plan or its communication strategy?
You know, first of all, I'll say we recognize that any change can be difficult. We've tried to, put our messaging out to Manitobans, and I get it. There's a lot of, I won't call them special interests, but there's a lot of obviously interested parties that are more at stake than others when it comes to change. Clearly, they've been vocal. And I would say to you, misrepresenting what we're trying to accomplish here. I understand people will disagree, but we want to make sure they're making their decisions based on facts. That's why over the course of the last little while, and we will continue to provide Manitobans the facts when it comes to what we're trying to accomplish in terms of better outcomes for our students in the K-12 system.
Our final reporter this afternoon from CTV Winnipeg, Josh.
Hi, Minister. Josh Crabb from CTV Winnipeg. Similar to Ian's question, I just spoke with a retired teacher of more than 30 years, maintains he's nonpartisan, but seems to have legitimate concerns about centralization of the education system. What would you say in response to people who do have concerns based on the facts laid out in the fact and fiction page that your government released?
Yeah, a few things. Obviously, times change. Roles and responsibilities of school trustees have changed. Our view is we want Manitoba parents engaged in the process more than they have been. Clearly, results show the more engagement parents have, the better outcomes they have for our students. And we think that is critical. We're going to empower school leadership through principals who understand education very well. That's what they're trained to do, and we're going to empower them to do that. School community councils will provide advice on priorities for the local school to the leadership, but the leadership will deliver education, and we're respectful of that. We will have a oversight body to administer education, the Provincial Education Authority. We as a government will appoint directors to that body. It's clearly laid out in legislation, the expertise and the knowledge required under the legislation for these positions. So we will have a $3 billion budget under the Provincial Education Authority, and it will be responsible for delivering outcomes, better outcomes, for our Manitoba students. So we will have a diverse group, a knowledgeable group, to undertake that task.
Thank you for that. And there are more than, or I guess exactly 400 people signed up to speak to this bill later on in the fall at the committee hearings. What does that number tell you, if anything?
Yeah, I think as part of our COVID experience, we're everyone's doing more things remotely these days. So clearly, by doing that, more people have access to our committee hearings. And I think that's a positive thing. Clearly, I think Manitoba is one of the few provinces that actually do have these committee hearings. So I'm looking forward to that discussion for sure. It's good to see passion coming from Manitobans when it comes to K-12 education. Quite frankly, that's why we got involved in the K-12 review, because we think there's an opportunity to improve our system. And that's why we want to engage Manitobans over the next months and years to improve our education system. Clearly, the governance model is one component to it, and it is a change. It is certainly a change in terms of governance, and it has caught a lot of people's attention. We want to make sure that people are making those decisions based on the facts of the matter. And an opportunity such as today is a chance for us as government to remind people to get educated, to do your research, to make sure that you're making the decision based on the facts.
Thank you, Minister. Thanks, everyone. This concludes our media briefing.